I'm an LSA here at Cedar Hall School, and you'll mostly find me in the food tech room. Today I'm going to be showing you how to make pasta napoletana. It's a very quick and a very healthy dish to make. Before you start cooking, you need to remember, if you have long hair, you need to tie it back like what I have. And after that, you need to make sure you wash your hands for 20 seconds at least, and that will prevent any kind of cross-contamination, any germs getting into your food, which you don't want. So here are the ingredients that I'm going to be using today. So I've got mushrooms, which are, if you're a vegetarian especially, they're a really good source of protein. I've got the sauce. So we've got tomato passata, which we're going to be using as the base sauce. A little bit of olive oil, and that's to stop your ingredients from sticking, and it adds a little bit of flavour as well. We've got some peppers. I've got a green and an orange one. Lots of vitamins in those, and some onion as well. And for seasoning, a little bit of mixed herbs, and as well a little bit of sugar in there, because passata is got quite a tangy taste to it, and so the sugar just helps to sweeten it up a little bit. And of course I have here 12 ounces of spaghetti, which I've weighed out. This is for myself and my family who I'm cooking for, but of course you measure out how much you see fit. I also have some chili flakes, which they're optional, but if you like a little bit of spice in your food, you can always add some of these. My knife for cutting up my ingredients with, a colander slash sieve for when you're draining your pasta, a food waste bin, and here I've got my pan ready with my oil in it. Which is what I'm going to put all of my vegetables and the sauce, that's where that's going to be. And I've already got my pan here with water on, simmering away, just waiting for me to add the pasta. So firstly I'm going to prepare my onions and also my peppers as well, so that they can get cooking. So I'm going to use the bridge hold here just to cut the onion. This is a very, very safe way to cut vegetables, especially difficult ones that roll around like this. So I'm going to use bridge hold, slice the onion, and then I'm going to use roll grip there as well. And now for preparing the pepper, what I'm going to do, so I'm going to cut it, turn it upside down, cut it down that, pull it apart, pull one half of the seeds out there, and then the other half as well, and there should be no seeds left in there now, and we're going to pop that in the bin. And same with the other pepper, and you turn it upside down, use your bridge hold to cut it down there, pull it apart again, and I'm going to slice all my peppers up into thin long slices like that. And then I'm going to cut them all in half again. Give all these ingredients a little bit of a stir around to stop them sticking. You can hear they're sizzling very nicely. Very nice. Next up we have our mushrooms. You don't have to, but if you feel like the skin is a little bit misshapen or discoloured, you can peel them, which is something that I enjoy doing anyway, so I always make an excuse to peel them. Claw hold with this one. These are small, thin. Also, mushrooms are optional. You don't have to put mushrooms in there, but like I say, if you're a vegetarian, they're a good source of protein. But you can also put other vegetables in as well. So you can put celery, if you like celery, sweet corn, maybe even broccoli. So now that my water has finished simmering, I'm going to put on my spaghetti to cook, to boil now. Oh, that could have gone a bit tidier than I planned, but there we go, it's all in there now, and thank you. All in, yep. Normally, pasta will be done within around 10 to 15 minutes. Also, don't forget to stir it a little bit as well when it first goes in, because pasta is quite a starchy food, and the starch sometimes makes it stick together, which is a little bit of a pain, so it's always good to give it a little bit of a stir once you've put it in to boil like that, and then you can just let it do its thing. I'm going to add my passata tomato sauce in with the vegetables here. Like that. There we go. And there's still quite a bit left in there, as you can see, so to prevent any waste, normally what I do is I put a little bit of water in the jar like that and give it a little bit of a swirl around like that, and then you can pour the rest in like that. So here I am adding just a small teaspoon of sugar, any kind of sugar will do, this is just golden sugar, that's just to sweeten up the sauce a little bit, as it can be quite tangy without it. So I'm just going to stir that in. This is also a good time to add your seasonings if you want seasonings. So yeah, I've got mixed herbs here. Put that there. And I'm chili flakes as well. Like I say, these are optional. Well, because not everyone likes spicy food. But if you do, they just add a little bit of a kick to it. So. Mix all those in. If you find that your sauce, your vegetable sauce, is too runny for your liking, you can also add a little bit of corn flour mixed with water, and that helps to thicken the sauce up a little bit, which is what I'm going to do. So if your corn flour mixture, if you do need it, so normally I just use like a heaped teaspoon of corn flour. Maybe a tiny bit more. There we go. And then I'm going to put a little bit of water in there as well and mix it around. Mix it around a little bit so it looks kind of like milk.
Let's pour that in there.
Thickening up the sauce a little bit. Stirring that. I've got to say, it smells rather delicious. Just checking on the pasta. That looks like it's nearly done, so soon I'll be able to drain that through the colander. So one of the final things you can do before serving up your meal is grate in some cheese. As I know, this is probably quite a popular topping to have on your pasta. It certainly is for me. I love cheese a lot, and especially again if you're a vegetarian, cheese is a very, very good source of protein and also a good source of calcium as well. So I'm just gonna grate cheese in here. Muscle work. It's going everywhere. The good thing about this grater is that it's got a container to catch it at the bottom, so. So that is my cheese. I think I might have done a little bit too much there, but I'm sure it'll all get used. And remember to put your cheese back in the fridge after you finish with it, because it is a dairy product. And so we need to make sure to keep it stored safely so it doesn't go off.
Now I'm going to drain my pasta in my colander. Excess